Hi folks, this is David Kwan, and recently, I think a couple of weeks back, I talked about my thoughts on Assassin's Creed series as a whole, and I talked a lot about Assassin's Creed 1 and 2, and a little bit about 4, but I didn't really talk that much about 3 other than to say this is like one of my least favorite games in the franchise as a whole. And this is also, to qualify, I didn't play some Assassin's Creed games. I didn't play the one for the Vita, Assassin's Creed 3 Liberation. And I didn't play one for the PSP. And I didn't play one for the DS. DS one is like a spin-off. And there are some spin-offs also for the iPad and the App Store, like Assassin's Creed Pirates or something like that, which I actually tried playing on the iPad, but it crashed. I don't think my iPad can handle that game. Anyway, all that aside, so when I say Assassin's Creed 3 is my least favorite of the series, you know, there are some games that I haven't played that might actually be even less favorite if I do play them. But anyway, that aside, it's interesting though, because I think if I was to like score this as a video game reviewer, I would probably give it a really high score, Assassin's Creed 3. It does try a lot of things that the series has not tried before, and it accomplishes a lot with what it does. It's the effort. I mean, I can play this game and I can just see like there's so much effort done here. It is a team of hundreds of game designers and artists and sound producers and storyboard writers, like, all came together and made this kind of thing that pretty much is a masterpiece, except for the fact that it isn't very fun. You know, it's not very interesting. So other than those two things, which is, I think, probably two of the most important things, you know, for it to be a video game, you know, it should be fun, and it should be interesting. That's missing with Assassin's Creed 3. But other than that, it's a masterpiece, you know? So if I was a video game reviewer that was really kind of into, like, scoring it and making sure that the score is justified, I'd probably give it a pretty high score, like 8 or 8.5. Or maybe at the lowest, I could probably give it a 7.5 or something like that. But not lower than that, just because it's such a... It's a game that tries a lot. And it's a game that kind of begs me as a fan of the series to, like, I really, 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 really want to like this game. But I don't. And part of the, I think... It's hard to really say. Like, I think it really has to come down to a few things. So the character, the main character that you play as, such an interesting premise. You know, the concept on paper, in theory, is great. You get to play as for main part of the story. You know, you start the game as a British character, Haytham, and he's a really badass, and he's like, oh, wait, and then you find out at the end of the first chapter, like, oh, he's actually not an assassin. Holy crap, what the hell? And then he he had sexual relations and romantic relations with a Native American woman, and that's the main character that you play as throughout the rest of the game, as Connor, who is the son of Haytham, but also the son of the woman in the Native American tribe that I forgot the name of. I don't know what the tribe's name is. I totally forget. But he also has a really interesting, complicated Native American name that I can't pronounce. So that's the premise. You know, you have a guy who's kind of conflicted in the time period of the American Revolutionary War. And it's an interesting premise. But the way they show this character or have this character be portrayed is just dull and boring. He has really no personality other than just being like, oh, I need to get this done. You know, oh, I'm going to help you. I don't know why I'm doing this, but I'm going to do it. I need to do it. I need to kill Haytham. Like, it's really hard to discern what his motivation is, and especially at the end of the game. At the very ending of the game is when I was like, what was the point of all that for Connor, really? Connor has, like, no real reaction to the things that actually happen. You know, so that's, I think, one of the biggest problems is Connor himself. You have this character who has potential to be such an amazing character. You don't really see, in the video game universe, a main character you play as a main protagonist playable character who is Native American. So rare. Could you, you know, try to name some games that do that? You could probably name some that are like in with one hand or two hand or less than that, you know? So very unique concept, very unique history too, because you actually get to play as his father at one point, you know, in the beginning of the game. But it's not utilized. There's no advantage of that, you know? So I think that is a big miss over there. Another, and the beginning of the story is so slow. It's Assassin's Creed, I think, the 3 is the one that has a really, really slow going. Because you have to repeat it twice. You have a slow going in the beginning. You're in the seas. You're kind of walking around in the boat, not doing much of anything. And then it has a really slow beginning after you become Connor as a kid, playing hide and seek and doing all these hunting stuff and seeing the story unfold. The story is also the main problem here, because it's a Revolutionary War. You get to meet these kind of characters that are taught a lot in American history courses. So a lot of the audiences, many of them are American audiences, so they should be familiar with this setting, with the characters, with the people in the setting, but it doesn't feel unique, it doesn't feel interesting. You know, there's no intrigue that's been held in Assassin's Creed 1 and Assassin's Creed 2 that kind of is like, you know, this whole conspiracy theory between Assassins versus Templars carrying on to the modern day conspiracy. There's no intrigue behind this, and I think that's part of the reason why Assassin's Creed 3 is such a boring game. The story gets really, really boring, and it becomes really problematic near the end, when, you know, Connor says stuff like, you know, this is for freedom, and things like that, and it's almost becomes like, kind of Haytham has his own motives too, and at this point, like, this game really makes you think, like, well, are the Assassins any better than Templars? Are the Templars any better than Assassins? It really makes you question that, but not in a good way. It's not a very thought-provoking game. It's just like, I don't really get the point, you know? So, the biggest reasons I don't like Assassin's Creed 3 really are the character, the story, and the setting could have been more interesting. It's set in Philadelphia. It's set in New York. It's set in Boston. It's set in these extremely famous cities, you know, and they all feel the same. It's just like a very square buildings, with churches that when you climb onto the top, it's the cross that you climb onto the top. A lot of the similar looking buildings, a lot of the activities that you do are you're going to be running on rooftops, chasing the almanac pages that are missing that Ben Franklin wants to collect. That's the kind of, the only reason Ben Franklin is there is to collect the almanac pages. Like, they could have done something more with these historical figures like Ben Franklin and George Washington. But they really did not utilize that all too much. The crazy Revolutionary War battle sequences are really impressive. But again, not very all that fun. Okay, so now we're going into gameplay. Major thing with the gameplay is stealth is broken in this game. It's so hard to be stealthy in this game. But it doesn't really matter because Connor is so freaking powerful. Combat is so easy in this game. You could just, one man as Connor can take down so many people. And there are mission parameters that make the missions difficult, but it's frustrating difficult, not like challenging difficult like Demon Souls or Dark Souls. You know, so gameplay is frustrating, boring, the only thing really, really going for Assassin's Creed 3 is the production value, really. You get to go into the forest areas, and doing parkour in the forest is pretty amazing. Although it gets a little tricky figuring out how Connor can get to that tree, or gets the slip-ups, whatever. There's a hunting aspect, which, you know, but it's this whole expanse of land that you get to kind of just marvel at and revel at, which is really cool. Graphics are pretty amazing with this game. The ship battles, I think Assassin's Creed 3 began it, and it's really interesting. Although it doesn't really get too deep. It's with Assassin's Creed 4 that the naval battles get like, okay, so this is where Assassin's Creed wants to go with naval battles, and it's amazing. But three kind of sets the premise for that, and it doesn't really get that interesting, but it's pretty cool otherwise. But overall, that's the major feeling I get with Assassin's Creed 3, is that it could be considered like a masterpiece, I suppose, but it's a very boring one. This is a kind of similar feeling I had with some other games. I felt this way with Final Fantasy XII. I thought that was like, if I was a reviewer, I would probably score that game super high, you know, maybe 9, 8.5, but I was really bored throughout the entire experience. Call of Duty 2 is another game like that. That it was a very well done, well made game, but I just didn't have any fun. Assassin's Creed 3 is the sad game for me. It's a very ambitious game, tries to do a lot of things. It has a lot of interesting things in theory, but implemented and executed was done in a very uninteresting and dull and boring ways. I use those adjectives a lot in this video, boring and dull and not interesting, but that's really kind of the general feeling I get with Assassin's Creed 3. It was just not very fun. And with Assassin's Creed 3, you know, when I finished it, I was like feeling like, can the series actually go anywhere from here? You know, I'm feeling like negative. Then I got into Assassin's Creed 4 and I was like, okay, that game kind of, you know, changed my mind about where the series was going. Of course, Unity's out and now Rogue is out, and I guess I've been reading some reviews, I haven't played those, and I guess the general feeling is Assassin's Creed fatigue has kind of started to set in, and so that's interesting to see, even though Unity, it looks even more amazingly gorgeous, but I guess there's a lot of bugs in that one. Rogue, I haven't read too much about Rogue, but I guess it just feels kind of been there, done that kind of feeling with Assassin's Creed. So that's another thing to kind of be on the lookout for. Where can Assassin's Creed go from here, now that we've gone all this way? I think the main problem really is that Ubisoft wants to make this an annual series. Assassin's Creed every year. Two Assassin's Creed this year. You know, two Assassin's Creed games in a single year. I think it's just like, it's a little too much. There is an Assassin's Creed fatigue. This is an amazing series. But now, without Desmond, so Assassin's Creed 3 does away with Desmond. The ending of this game, like I said, the story is so bothersome. Like, about the Revolutionary American War setting story and the modern setting of this whole, you know, Desmond thing, how that ended. And Assassin's Creed 4 doesn't really tie that in, which I think was disappointing. There's no intrigue anymore. So I think that's what I want to see with the next Assassin's Creed. I want that intrigue back. The conspiracy, the Assassin's Creed and Templar intrigue, it needs to be reintroduced into the series, because that's one thing that's, I think, is starting to really miss from the series going forward, and that's really disappointing in my opinion. Anyway, I rambled off for a long time about Assassin's Creed 3, but that's generally my thoughts about Assassin's Creed 3 and why I think it's my least favorite of all the Assassin's Creed games I've played so far. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.